What's up, guys? This is the daily energy reading for twin flames, divine masculine, divine feminine energies, leading you to more life, and union up your dualities internally and externally. First off, excuse my shirt, my attire today. I did not feel like getting special. I cut the grass today and I showered and got my son ready, you know, coached him through getting himself ready for school, and I am tired. So I did not feel like putting on like a sweater or anything special. So you guys are gonna have to take the shirt that I gave today. This energy reading today is brought to you by The Power of I Am. I am the creator and the creator is in me. It's my book on Amazon, my ebook. Paperback. I might finish the paperback soon. I don't know. I just wanted to get some more buzz on the ebook first. But it teaches you about the twin flame, divine masculine and divine feminine energies, and unification of your dualities as well. How to operate as God on earth. This reading is so dope. The overall energy of this reading, no, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed. That just came on mind, I'm going with it. No, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed. And we have temperance on the bottom of the deck, which is balance, tranquility, peace, harmony within yourself. And I know why. This is because the first two cards, tarot cards we have is the Ace of Cups and the Ace of Swords. There's two aces starting off. So this is not just about you. This is about you and your divine partner. Both of you, this is fulfillment. This is happiness. This is clarity of thought. This is breakthrough in life. This is new beginnings. This is partnership, but this is you two leveling up together. So this energy is not just for one divine person. I'm not just talking about you. I'm talking about you and your divine partner, your divine masculine and feminine energies together, but also your partners as well. So this is about two people coming together and leveling up. Makes sense that the next card is the Four of Wands. Unity, balance, but celebration, happiness, achievement. But not by yourself. Again, together. Both of you achieving, both of you coming together, both of you experiencing harmony and bliss in your life. Then we have the Knight of Swords and the Queen of Pentacles. The Knight is, if you look at these cards together, the Knight is looking at the Queen. But, you know, these cards, the energy, you know how the Knight of Swords is usually about diligently going after your goals until you get it. This Knight is kind of calm, though, I'm getting. He's going after her, but it's from a sense of, she's already mine. So the energy that I'm getting from this divine partner is, yeah, I'm going after what I want, but she's already mine. So it's like, this is after you guys come together. This isn't the chase. This isn't about the chase. This is for people who are about to, who have already came together. And when you come together, or this could be a look into the future. When you come together, both of you level up. See how it's two aces and then Knight and the Queen coming together? The next is the Nine of Pentacles. The Queen and the Nine of Pentacles go together. The Queen is, first of all, it's five, one, two, three, four, five pentacles in its reading. That's more than half. That's about half the cards. Money, money, money. And I don't want to sing this song. It's coming in my head. I don't know why. But you know that song, money, 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 money. It's in my head. I just had to say that. Anyway, it's like new levels of abundance. The Queen has the Nine of Pentacles. So that's what happens first. The Queen levels up. She gets her abundance. She gets her money. She's about her stuff. She's stable. She's nurturing her projects and ideas, bringing them to life and making money. She's into her new levels and new phases of life. She's abundant and happy by herself already. Then, the king levels up. Oh my God, y'all, I cannot make this up. And these cards just filled out. And I was like, okay, I'll take them. Look how the knight turns into the king. First he's the knight, then he levels up and comes to the King of Pentacles. Look at that suit. He levels up, then the king levels up. But the card next to the king is the Ten of Pentacles. So it's like, queen, she levels up to the Nine of Pentacles. Then the king levels up to the Ten of Pentacles. So that's next level. So it's like, how you gonna upgrade an upgrader? You know how Beyonce and Jay-Z say that? How you gonna upgrade an upgrader? It's like, queen is upgrading, King is upgrading. They upgrade each other because this is happening individually in their lives, but it's happening as a union. Like they're both coming together, and coming together levels each other up. And the last time we have is the Six of Pentacles, balance. Again, what I just said, coming together levels each other up, and they both provide balance in each other's life. And I'm not even I'm talking about balance and equal give and take in a relationship. I'm talking about balance in this is who I want as a person. This is who I want to be as a person. If I was a woman, I would want to be you. This is like meeting that person that adds to you and meeting that person that levels you up in life, leveling each other up, but keeping each other grounded at the same time. It's like we're leveling up together, but we're remaining grounded. We're remaining solid with who we are, remaining in tune with God and our feminine energies, being the people that we were created to be, and entering new phases of life, not individually, but together. That was a really dope reading. And I could dig more into it, but I don't think there is a need to dig more into it. You know, I try to talk more than 6 minutes for these readings. This is going to be the shortest reading I've done. But it's really no more to be said. Basically, coming together, you experience fulfillment, breakthroughs, clarity of mind, clarity of thought. You know who you are. You know who your partner is. There is no need to think about it. There is no demonic activity in this reading. This is all abundance, happiness, overflow, increase, next leveling. But individually coming to the next level, but as a partnership as well. The Knight turns into the King. The Queen upgrades Nine of Pentacles and abundance and blessings in her life. The King brings in Ten of Pentacles, completion, entering new levels, and they both bring balance into each other's life. This is so dope. Why? Because they're together. Because they're in union. And that's what it's supposed to be like when you're in union with your divine partner. You level each other up. You keep each other grounded. There's equal give and take. And it's what you want and expect in the partner. And it's, you don't have to work. When you're together, you don't have to work hard for it. Because the hard work was in the chase. The hard work was in bringing you two together. The hard work was in the lessons you had to learn before you came together. Now it's time for new levels. Now when you come together, it's time for breakthroughs. Now when you come together, it's time for hard work, dedication. But together, leveling up in life and using that information, knowledge, and resources that you gain from this powerful relationship, from the power within yourself and the power of unification of your dualities, to level other people up as well. This reading is so dope. I'm so glad I took these cards. So find a necessary balance. So if you find yourself imbalanced, if you find yourself in whatever area of your life, you're lacking feminine energy, you're lacking masculine energy, go ahead and balance it. Work on yourself and get yourself so that both of you guys can level up. Because if one person is leveling up and the other person is not, it don't fit this reading. This reading is for two people who individually level up, but level it up times that when they're together. Again, it starts with two aces. This is about a pair. And then the Knight and the Queen, and then the Queen and the Nine, and the King and the Ten. This is about pair. And then the Six of Pentacles and the Four of Wands. Both of these are about pairs. All of these cards are about pairs. Coming together and leveling each other up, but also leveling themselves up. So make sure you're doing the work on yourself to prepare yourself for this level of partnership. Because a King ain't gonna want a bum. So if you're not handling your shit, you're not handling your business, maybe the King, and the King is, that's not equal give and take. That's not Six of Pentacles relationship. Because one person is leveling up and the other is not. And that is resentment. That opens the door for resentment, codependency, jealousy. You don't want that in your relationship. But when your divine partnership comes together, twin flames, both of them have it working on their selves, the dualities, the unification of dualities of themselves and balancing within themselves and leveling up their lives individually. So when they come together, it's on a whole new level. Look at this. Nine of Pentacles, Ten of Pentacles, Queen of Pentacles, King of Pentacles. This is like leveling up on all levels of life, especially financially. Abundance, power, stability, new phases of life, new levels, new money, new mindset, clarity of thought, power in knowing who you are, and fulfillment. That sounds like a life to me. Anyway, if you resonate with this reading, click the thumbs up, like, subscribe, comment, let me know how you feel about it. If you need anything from me, don't forget this is sponsored by The Power of I Am. It's on Amazon, and it's also in a link in my description. If you need anything from me, feel free to contact me. I wish you love, light, and more life.
Come to the edge, he said. We might fall, they said. Come to the edge, he said. It's too high, they said. Come to the edge, he said. They came, he pushed them, and they flew.